Norman Hunter with 540 league games. What a combination.
He was a terrific player, Norman Hunter. Played alongside Jack Charlton. Terrific left foot. Read things very, very well, but a great user of the ball. Could deal with the ball in tight situations. Very, very unfortunate at the time because a certain Robert Moore was occupying his position in the England team.
Got three West Ham defenders surging around him, but he finds now Peter Lorimer inside for Johnny Giles. And Hunter coming up fast to drive it. Oh, and what a goal! What a goal by Norman Hunter!
We talk about this the Don Revy era and the fantastic success, not out of the top four, you know, between, well, virtually for a decade. Two league titles, cups as well, but should you have won more than you did? Were you unfortunate not to win more than you did?
Well, I've always said that I used to think we got, not at the time, but now, that we got involved in too many competitions. You know, every year we're involved in about everything, the domestic and European. And then one game, one important game, just rolled into another. There was no sort of excitement about a semi-final coming up or a quarter-final of this or that. The only time we turned around and won things quite easy was one year we weren't going to win the league, so we said, we'll go win the FA Cup. What did we do? We went and won the FA Cup. And then another year, we were out of all the competitions, he said, we'll go and win the league. And we went and won the league. So I think we got a little bit too involved in too many competitions. And also, not sour grapes, we did have one or two bad decisions that went against us in really, really big games.
Apart from the decisions,
Costas
Daly.
The West Bromwich thing.
West Brom thing. Costas two titles. That we lost it that year. And then the following year,
we
had to go and play X amount of games away from Allen Road. And we dropped points.
Just explain what happened in that West Brom game, because it was virtually a riot there, wasn't there?
Well, I'm probably the best one to do, because I was the one that passed the ball to Johnny Giles that got intercepted. But and as Tony Brown went through, the lad Suddick, he was up there, so he was miles offside. So the linesman did that. And bearing in mind, the referee had been taking notice of the linesman all game, so all of a sudden...
It was Jeff Astle, wasn't it?
And he went, and the ref put his flag down. And then he went on, and then he passed it forward again to Jeff Astle, who tapped it in the net. And then we went absolutely berserk. Well,
and the cross wouldn't come over as Hughes wanted it. He delayed it for a moment and Reaney was able to just get in a tackle, or at least half a tackle. Hunter, what tremendous confidence there all along the penalty area, past three Sunderland players by Norman Hunter.
Well, it's got to be Jack Charlton and Norman Hunter. Brawn and brain. One trips him and the other clips him. I'll leave you to decide which. No. I can't think of a better pairing in this country for since the war.
Sent off that day. I got a bit frustrated and had a kick at somebody, and then it went on from there. But I remember walking round, and I had my medal. I walked around with Terry Ellis, and their fans, they were running round with a cup, and they were chanting, "Cheats, cheats." I remember standing there, I looked at this medal, and I nearly chucked it. I nearly chucked it in the mud.
more together at the moment than England are. Donaghy. Bremner. Is going to be consistent. He's got to show him the card as well.
The final whistle went, we'd lost, and the ball came to me. I picked the ball up, and all their players were saying, "Can I have the ball?" And I said, "No, no, you can't." And I kept it. Well, they were trying to get it off me, and I kept a hold of it. And I remember coming, and Terry Urith came over, and known Terry a long time, and there was tears in his eyes, and he was crying. And I lost my temper, didn't I? Again, I looked at this football. I kicked it, and when it had gone 10 yards, I wanted it back. I wanted that ball, but I went, and I threw it up, and I whacked this ball, and it flew up in the bloody stand. And then when it had gone, I thought, what are you doing? I could have got that signed and could have kept it and everything. Just lost my temper.
And Kendall. By Hunter, and that's Howard Kendall out for the count.
It was in an article, one of the newspaper fellows wrote it in an article, and that was the first I really heard of it, and then it was at the cup final, and then I remember getting an income tax return, and there was a little note in, there was the income tax return, and there was a little note saying, "Norman, keep biting," you know. But it's light-hearted. No, it's not serious, you know. So it's a good thing.